नेक्स्ट बीट मेटालिक एंड नॉन मेटालिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ द ऑफ मॉडर्न पीरियोडिक टेबल. सो स्टूडेंट्स सी हियर, लुक एट द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द थर्ड पीरियड, क्लासीफाई देम इंटू मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. सम क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन हियर. थर्ड पीरियड एलिमेंट्स एंड वी हैव टू क्लासीफाई दीज मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. ऑन विच साइड द पीरियड आर द मेटल्स लेफ्ट और राइट? ऑन विच साइड ऑफ द पीरियड डिड यू फाइंड द नॉन मेटल्स? सो वी नो दैट द मॉडर्न पीरियडिक टेबल, इन द मॉडर्न पीरियडिक टेबल द एलिमेंट्स आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ दियर एटॉमिक नंबर. सो सी हियर, दिस इज द थर्ड पीरियड. दिस इज द थर्ड पीरियड. The elements in third period, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, these are the third period elements. So student, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, these elements are the metallic elements, while phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, these are the non-metallic elements, while silicon is having property similar as the metals as well as non-metal, so that silicon is considered as metalloid. See here, this is the picture given in your textbook, periodic trends in the elements. Here we are writing down the elements which are present in the third period. This is the third period. This is third period. If we write the elements in the third period, suppose this is sodium, then magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and argon, then we come to know that the sodium, magnesium, aluminium, up to the blocks which are having color bluish color, ja blocks la bluish color ne color kelele, all these elements shows the metallic properties. While the elements which are present in the yellow colored box, these are metalloid elements. And the elements which are present in the green colored box, these are non-metals. So that the phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, these are the non-metals. While argon, we know that argon is a inert gaseous element. Now what is given in the metallic and non-metallic property of the element? It is seen that the metallic elements like sodium, magnesium are towards the left. The non-metallic elements sulfur, chlorine are towards the right. The metalloid element silicon lies in between these two types. A similar pattern is observed in the other periods also. ज्यावेळेस आपण पिरियॉडिक टेबलचा अभ्यास करतो तर आपल्याला असं आढळून येतं की जे मेटलॉइड एलिमेंट्स आहेत या ठिकाणी ही जी झिगझॅग लाईन दिसून येते या झिगझॅग लाईनच्या बॉर्डरला जे काही एलिमेंट्स आहेत ते सगळे मेटालॉइड एलिमेंट्स आहे. एलिमेंट्स विच आर प्रेझेंट लेफ्ट टू द पिरियॉडिक टेबल, ऑल दीज आर मेटल. द एलिमेंट्स विच आर प्रेझेंट राईट ऑफ द पिरियॉडिक टेबल, दीज आर नॉन मेटल्स. अँड प्रेझेंट अँड दी द एलिमेंट्स विच आर प्रेझेंट इन बिटवीन देम, दीज आर द मेटालॉइड एलिमेंट्स. Then next, it's seen that the zigzag line separates the metals from the non-metals in the periodic table. Elements appear to have arranged in such a way that the metals are on the left side of the on this line and non-metals are the right side. Metalloids are along the border of this line. How did this happen? So student, in modern periodic table, just we have seen that ki along the zigzag line, all the metalloid elements are present. Left to the zigzag line, metals are present, and right to the zigzag line, non-metals are present. And along the zigzag line, metalloid elements are present. तर यात मागचं कारण काय आहे किंवा how did this happen? Let us compare the characteristic chemical properties of the metals and non-metals. तर हे समजून घेण्यासाठी we must know the characteristic properties of the metals and non-metals. What are the chemical properties of the metals and non-metals? It is seen from the chemical formulae of the simple ionic compound that the cation in them are formed by the metal, while the anion from a non-metal. From this is it is understood that the metal atoms have a tendency to form a cation by losing its valence electron. This property is called electropositivity of an element. On the other hand, an atom of non-metal has tendency to form anion. By accepting the electrons from outside its valence shell, we have already seen that ions have a stable electronic configuration of a noble gas. How is this ability to lose or accept the electrons in the valence shell determined? All the electrons in any atoms are held by the attractive force exerted on them by positively charged nucleus. So students, here any ionic compound, we see the example of sodium chloride, this ionic compound. Sodium having electronic configuration 2, 8, 1, sodium loses one electron and produces the sodium positive ion, which is a cation. And simultaneously, the chlorine having 2, 8, 7 electronic configuration, it accepts the electron, produces chloride ion, that means anion. And due to the force of attraction between sodium positive and chloride negative, it gives the formation of sodium chloride. That means as a sodium is a metallic element, that means its nature is electropositive nature, because it produces the cation. Because sodium is having tendency to lose the electrons, while chlorine is a non-metal and it is having tendency to accept electron, producing anion, chloride ion, so that it is a electronegative element. Ma, these elements, manje ki ya elements la konta basis varti metals and non-metals, how is the ability, one question is given here, see, how is the ability to lose or accept the electrons in the valence shell determined? The valence shell madle electrons se accept karayche ka lose karayche he kontya basis var determine kele jata. All the electrons in any atom are held by the attractive force exerted on them by positively charged nucleus. Electrons in the inner shells lies in between the valence shell and nucleus. Because of their presence of the effective nuclear charge, exerting an attractive force on the valence electron is somewhat less than the actual nuclear charge. So student, we know that the sodium is having, for example, sodium is having atomic number 11, 2, 8, 1, this is an electronic configuration. The first shell of the sodium is having 2 electrons. Second shell contains 8 electrons, while the outermost shell contains only a single electron. So from the, this is the nucleus, and ya nucleus pasun ya outermost shell cha madhe je kahi shells astat, tya shells la apan inner shells manto. So there is a force of attraction is strong in between the electrons present in the inner shell with the nucleus. The nucleus madhe je protons astat, ya protons sobat je force of attraction asti electrons shi related, electrons sobat, तो इनर शेल मध्ये असलेल्या इलेक्ट्रॉन सोबत तो जास्त असतो एज कंपेयर्ड टू द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेझेंट इन द व्हॅलेन्स शेल. बिकॉज ऑफ दियर प्रेझेन्स द इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज एक्झर्टिंग अन अट्रॅक्टिव फोर्स ऑन द व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन इज समवॉट लेस दॅन द ॲक्च्युअल न्यूक्लियर चार्ज. दस द नंबर ऑफ व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन इन इज द मेटल्स इज स्मॉल 1, 2, 3. आपण पाहतोय की या सेकंड पिरियड थर्ड पिरियडमध्ये जे एलिमेंट्स आहे सोडियम मॅग्नेशियम ॲल्युमिनियम यांच्या व्हॅलेन्स शेलमध्ये 1, 2, 3 असे नंबर ऑफ व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आहेत. दीज आर द मिनिमम व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रेझेंट इन द मेटॅलिक एलिमेंट्स. ऑल्सो द इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज एक्झर्टिंग द अट्रॅक्टिव फोर्स ऑन द व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन इज स्मॉल. आणि त्या व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉनवरती जो काही ॲक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्जद्वारे जो फोर्स ऑफ अट्रॅक्शन ॲट्रॅक्टिव फोर्स जो प्रयुक्त होतो हा खूप स्मॉल असतो. ॲज कंबाइंड इफेक्ट दीज टू फॅक्टर्स, कोणते दोन फॅक्टर, एक तर लेस नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रेझेंट इन द व्हॅलेन्स शेल अँड अनादर इज इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज एक्झर्टिंग अट्रॅक्टिव फोर्स ऑन द व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन इज स्मॉल. ॲज कंबाइंड इफेक्ट ऑफ दीज टू फॅक्टर्स द मेटल्स हॅव टेंडन्सी टू लूज द व्हॅलेन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन टू फॉर्म द कॅटायन्स हॅविंग स्टेबल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक नोबल गॅस कॉन्फिग्युरेशन. दीज टेंडन्सी ऑफ एलिमेंट्स कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रोपॉझिटिव्हिटी इज द मेटॅलिक कॅरेक्टर ऑफ दॅट एलिमेंट. सीयर all the metals which are present in the blue colored boxes all these elements are metals and they are electropositive in nature. And see here the third point, decreasing electropositivity, metallic character. When we go left to right in case of the period, we come to know that there is a decreasing metallic character of the elements. म्हणजे डिक्रीजिंग इलेक्ट्रोपॉजिटिविटी डिक्रीज होते आणि मेटॅलिक कॅरेक्टरसुद्धा डिक्रीज होताना दिसून येतो वेन वी गो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राईट इन अ पिरियड. सो स्टुडंट, फ्रॉम द पॉईंट मेटॅलिक अँड नॉन मेटॅलिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द नॉन मेटॅलिक कॅरेक्टर्स ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स, द रिमेनिंग पार्ट वी विल डिस्कस इन अवर नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ. थँक्यू.